Cardinal Fang! Fetch the comfy chair.
Yes, that's right. Pull up your comfy chair, grab a coffee, sit down, and watch.
During the meanwhile.
Well, hello. It's Dexter and me, back with yet another unmissable episode of, what's it called? Tech Tuesday, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the little introduction to today's film. We had a great deal of fun coming up with that concept and filming it as well. And yeah, hopefully, fingers crossed, the award is in the post. Right, today's Tech Tuesday is the long promised review of my iFootage TC7 Fastbowl tripod. Now, I've had this a good few months now. I can't remember exactly when I bought it. Was it about last September, October time, I think? So I feel pretty well qualified now to give you my thoughts on this tripod. Before I go into the whys and wherefores of it though, some stats. It's quite a large, it's a full size tripod. It's not a travel tripod by any means. It's around, is it something like 66 centimeters, so over 2 foot. This is without the head when folded up. So it's quite a thing to cart around. And then fully extended, again, without the head and with the legs, in their normal position. It's about 5 foot, just over 5 foot or 155 centimeters tall. And with the legs fully splayed out, you can get it down to around about 6 or 7 inches or 18 centimeters off the ground. And weight wise, it is no Kate Moss. It's around about 4 pounds or 1.86 kilos, there or thereabouts. Right. Why did I buy this? I got quite a few tripods in my collection, and the one that I've been using for many years for my landscape photography was my three-legged thing, Brian, with its Airhead One. A fantastic tripod, but more of a travel tripod really. So when I got my GFX 50R, I was using that with the Brian tripod, and was always thinking I needed something a little bit more sturdy to hold it up, especially after I got my Benro geared head. I always felt that the tripod was this kind of like weak link in the stability chain, if you like. I hankered after something different, and after a fair bit of research and you know whatnot, and facing up to the reality that I was shooting more and more panoramas, to be honest.
Don't listen to him. The man's got a bad case of gas. That's all.
I wanted something more suited to that kind of workflow. So I went with this iFootage TC7 Fastbowl tripod. And now what the Fastbowl gives you is a really easy way to level the tripod's base plate, and therefore the head and the camera. So when you're shooting panoramas, it's much easier to make sure that everything is perfectly straight and level, and you get fewer, you know, white bits surrounding your panoramic image. And that's really why I bought it. Price wise, it cost me, I think, about £300, and they're around about that now on Amazon. So they're not a cheap tripod, but not, you know, hideously expensive. Anyway, to get into the review, the good points first. It is very solid and sturdy carbon fiber construction. The quick release leg locks are superb. They're very, very sturdy, very easy to use, very smooth in their operation, and they lock the legs really well. Extending or folding the legs in and out, very easy, very well engineered piece of kit, I would say. As I mentioned with the stats, it can get very, very tall to the extent that I can't even see my camera's viewfinder. So by the time I put like the head on top of the tripod and then my camera on top of that, I can't reach the camera's viewfinder sometimes. So it can get very, very tall. And you can also get really close to the ground with it for some lovely close-up, you know, macro type images, if you like. As I said, the bowl head makes it so much easier to level your camera out for panoramic or multi-shot compositions, so much easier. And coupled then with my Benro geared head, it makes shooting panoramas an absolute breeze, to be honest. And to that end, the actual little bubble head in the bowl heads, the bowl column thingy in that base plate, that bubble head or bubble level, I can still see it even with my Benro geared head attached. So that's obviously very, very handy in leveling everything off. Price-wise, as I said, it's around about £300, but I still think it offers, for what it is, a carbon fibre, full-size tripod capable of holding a substantial kit. What you get for your money, it's very, very good. There are a couple of not-so-good points, though. First one for me is the spikes. There are built-in spikes in the tripod feet, and there's like a little rubber bung which you can either screw out or screw in to reveal or hide the spikes. But the spikes, they're too short. They're too short to be of any use at all. You cannot, you know, really push them into the ground. They're only about that much spike visible. Unless I'm missing something or doing something wrong, if I am, please let me know in the comments below. But I find the spikes in use absolutely pointless, to be honest. There is no built-in like screw to attach a weight or your camera bag to the short center column. There's nothing built in. So what I've done is install my own using a simple stainless steel cup hook and a normal drywall roll plug. The only other negative point really is the tripod size. It's not a travel tripod, it is a full-size tripod. So if you are attaching it to your bag to cart around, it can be a little bit unwieldy. Now, for regular viewers or subscribers to this channel, you will know that I've converted tripod into a tripod cum walking support, so I don't attach it to my bag anymore. I use it as a walking stick, so I really don't have that problem. But when I was attaching it to my bag, it was quite hard to cinch down because of the sheer size of the thing. And that really is about all I have to say about this tripod.
Thank God for that.
I've just found it really easy to use, very, very sturdy. Like I said with my camera bag review, all you want a camera bag to do is protect your camera kit and make it easy to carry around. And all you want a tripod to do really is to securely support your camera and lens when you're shooting. And to that end, it's a 10 out of 10 tripod. All right, a 9 out of 10 then, because of the spikes. That's the one real negative point for me. Anyway, that is it for this week's Tech Tuesday. Thanks ever so much, as usual, for watching. Dexter, I really do appreciate your views and your support and interaction with the channel. Okay, we will see you, if not on Saturday, It'll be next Tuesday with a little chat about a piece of kit I've bought to make using my GFX 100 a lot easier for me. So you may be able to guess what that is, you may not, but I'll reveal what it is next Tuesday. And yeah, we'll see you in the meantime. All the very best. Bye-bye.